Hi, welcome to my first video in this tutorial. The first chapter is sets, functions and relations. In this video, we are going to focus on four topics. First is definition of a set. Definition of a set. Types of sets, and the third one is properties of set operations, and then Cartesian product. In this video, we are going to focus on these four things. I strongly recommend you to have a textbook with you for reference. So, இப்போ என்ன சொல்கிறேன், உங்கள் கையில் எப்பவுமே புக்கு வச்சுக்கோங்க, ரொம்ப யூஸ்ஃபுல்லாக இருக்கும். நான் சொல்ல சொல்ல நீங்கள் புக்கை பார்க்கலாம், உங்களுக்கு இன்னும் நல்லா புரியும். இப்போ நம்ம ஃபஸ்ட்டு என்ன பார்க்க போகிறோம் அப்படின்னா, டெஃபனிஷன் ஆஃப் அ செட். நவ் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சீ அ டெஃபனிஷன் ஆஃப் அ செட். டெஃபனிஷன் definition set. A set is a collection. A set is a collection of well-defined objects. So இப்ப நான் என்ன பண்ண போறேன் அப்படின்னா, first I am going to discuss what is meant by well-defined. The term well-defined is really, really important. So, when do we say that a set is well-defined? When do we say a set is well-defined? For example, if I have a set A is equal to some elements, suppose if I pick an element x in the set A, if I am able to tell whether that x is surely in that set, the set is well defined. Suppose if I am not clear whether this x is there or not, then the set is not well defined. இப்ப என்ன சொல்ல வரேன்னா, ஒரு எலமெண்ட் நான் x னு எடுக்கிறேன், அந்த எக்ஸ் கண்டிப்பாக ஏல இருக்கும் என்னால் சொல்ல முடிஞ்சதுன்னா அந்த செட் வெல் டிஃபைன்ட். சப்போஸ் இஃப் ஐ எம் நாட் ஏபிள் டு டெல், என்னால் சொல்ல முடியல, இருக்கலாம் இல்லாமையும் இருக்கலாம், அந்த மாதிரி இருந்ததுன்னா த செட் இஸ் நாட் வெல் டிஃபைன்ட். ஸோ எ செட் இஸ் அ கலெக்ஷன் ஆஃப் வெல் டிஃபைன்ட் ஆப்ஜெக்ட். நவ் ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு கிவ் அன் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஆஃப் விச் இஸ் நாட் அ செட். Which is not a set. Appana na ipa enna exam kudukka poran, a set which is not a set, appana adu not well defined. Example of sets which is not defined. See, suppose example 1. The collection of all beautiful flowers in the Ooty garden. This set is not well defined. Why? This set is not well defined because the term beautiful varies from person to person, content to content, object to object. The collection of all beautiful flowers in Ooty garden is not a set because it is not well defined, because the term beautiful varies from person to person. So இதில் என்ன சொல்ல வராங்க அப்படின்னா, பியூட்டி அப்படின்றது ஆளுக்கு ஆள் வேறுபடும். இப்போ சில பேருக்கு பியூட்டிஃபுல் ஃப்ளாராக தெரியறது, சில பேருக்கு தெரியாது. சில பேருக்கு பியூட்டிஃபுல்லாக இருக்கும், சில பேருக்கு பியூட்டிஃபுல்லாக இருக்காது. ஸோ த செட் இஸ் நாட் வெல் டிஃபைன்டு. சப்போஸ் இப் இட் இஸ் செட் ஏ இஸ் அ கலெக்ஷன் ஆஃப் ஆல் பியூட்டிஃபுல் ஃப்ளார்ஸ். சே ஏ இஸ் அ ஃப்ளவர், பி இஸ் அ ஃப்ளவர், சி இஸ் அ பியூட்டிஃபுல் ஃப்ளவர், டி இஸ் அ பியூட்டிஃபுல் ஃப்ளவர், அண்ட் இ இஸ் அ பியூட்டிஃபுல் ஃப்ளவர். திஸ் ஏபிசிடி ஆர் பியூட்டிஃபுல் ஃப்ளார். சப்போஸ் அ மேன் சே எக்ஸ் கம்ஸ், இ சேஸ் தட் ஏ இஸ் அ பியூட்டிஃபுல் ஃப்ளவர். இ சேஸ் தட் எக்ஸ் சேஸ் ஏ இஸ் பியூட்டிஃபுல் ஃப்ளவர். ஃபார் இம் எக்ஸ் பிலாங்ஸ் டு ஏ. அண்ட் அனதர் மென் சே ஒய் கம்ஸ் அண்ட் ஈ சேஸ் ஏ இஸ் நாட் பியூட்டிஃபுல். ஏ இஸ் நாட் பியூட்டிஃபுல். ஃபார் இம் எக்ஸ் டஸ் நாட் பிலாங்ஸ் டு ஏ. ஸோ I am not able to make a clear-cut definition whether that element belongs to the set or not. So, the set, the collection of all beautiful flowers in Ooty Garden is not a set because it is not well-defined. So, if it has to be a set, it has to be well-defined. Now, we are going to see another example of the set which is not defined. Example 2. The collection of all old men's in Tamil Nadu. Again, here The old man is not defined. Old man is not defined because a person of age 60 can also be a old man. Of age 70 can also be a possible candidate for an old man. 80 can be a old man. 90 can be a old man. So the old man is not well defined here. So this is not a set. So how can we make these two statements a set? The first example I given of which is not a set is the collection of all beautiful flowers in the Ooty Garden. The second is the collection of all old men in Tamil Nadu. These two are not sets. How can I make them as a set by altering the statement? These two statements can be made set by changing the collection of all red flowers in the Ooty Garden. Here the word red flowers is defined because no one can say this color is not a red because the red flower is clear cut. இது ரெட் என்னால் கண்டிப்பாக சொல்ல முடியும். அந்த ஃப்ளவர்ஸ்லாம் பிக் பண்ணி ஒரு கலெக்ஷன் ஆஃப் செட்ஸில் போட்டால் த ரெட் ஃப்ளவர் இஸ் வெல் டிஃபைன்ட். ஸோ திஸ் ஃபார்ம்ஸ் அ செட். நவ் How can I make the second statement, the collection of all old men in Tamil Nadu, as set? Suppose, if I change the statement as the collection of old men in Tamil Nadu of age more than 70. Here the more than 70 is descriptive. So this is well defined. So these two now forms a set. So what is a set? A set is a collection of well-defined object. The term well-defined has to be understand very, very, very clearly in order to go through the next topic. Clear? What is a set? A set is a collection of well-defined object. A set is a collection of well-defined object. Now, we are going into the next topic. The next topic is, what's the next topic? It is, we finished a definition. We finished the definition of a set. Now, we are going to see the types of sets. Types of sets. Types of sets. The first is empty set. Empty set. Empty set. A set. A set containing no element. A set containing no element is called empty set. Is called empty set. Is called empty set or void set. ஒரு செட்டில் எந்த எலமெண்டும் எந்த எலமெண்ட்டுமே இல்லை அப்படின்னா அந்த செட்டை நம்ம என்ன சொல்கிறோம்? எம்டி செட். எக்ஸாம்பிள் எக்ஸாம்பிள் செட் ஆஃப் ஆல் மந்த்ஸ் வித் 32 டேஸ். வெதர் திஸ் இஸ் பாசிபிள்? So there is no month with 32 days. So here A is empty. We denote the empty set by this simple, or we can simply denote this by these two empty parentheses. This is called parenthesis, or in fact I should say curly braces. This is an empty. These two are the symbols for empty set. Clear? An empty set, a set containing no elements is called empty set. Now second, subset. Subset. Let us consider two sets. Let A and B be two sets. Two sets. We say A is a subset of B. We use this symbol C and then underline to say a subset. We say A is a subset of B if every element of A is an element of B. Let A and B be two sets. We say A is contained in B. That is, A is a subset of B if every element of A is an element of B. Example, let A is equal to 1, 2, 3. B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here we see that every element of A is an element of B. So we call this A is a subset of B. Since every element of A is in B, so A is a subset of B. Empty set, a set containing no elements, is called an empty set or a void set. Second is subset. let A and B be two sets, we say that A is contained in B, that is A subset of B, if every element of A is an element of B. I given an example for an empty set and also for a subset. Now we're going to move to the third type of set, that is equal sets. That is equal sets. Equal sets. Equal sets. Two sets A and B. Two sets A and B are equal if A is a subset of B and B is a subset of A. Very simple. If every element of A is an element of B, and also every element of B is an element of A, then we call these two sets as equal. Example. Take A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We see that every element of A is an element of B, and also every element of B is an element of A. So therefore, these two sets are equal. So we say two sets are equal if A is contained in B and B is contained in A. So far we have seen three types of sets: empty set, the second is a subset, and third is a equal sets. Now you know what is meant by a subset. It is every element A is a subset of B if every element of A is an element of B. Suppose if I have a set A, suppose if I have a set A is equal to 1, 2, 3, then how many subsets I can form. So the empty set and the whole set is always a subset. So empty set and the whole set is always a subset. Then what are the different possibilities I can form? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 2, 3, and 3, 1. These are the possible subsets of A. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there are 8 subsets. When you look at this, these are all the subsets since every element of A is in that set. Now when you look at carefully, the number of elements in A is 3, so call that as n. So here A is equal to 1, 2, 3. Number of elements n is equal to 3 here. So we have formed 8 subsets from 3 elements, a set of 3 elements. In general, this is very important, this can be asked in 1 mark. In general, the number of subsets of n elements that can be formed is 2 power n. This is a very important formula. Now when you look at the above example, A consists of 3 elements, so we have formed 2 power 3, that is 8 subsets. Suppose if A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, then how many subsets we can form? That is, here n here, n is equal to 4, total number of elements. So, 2 power 4 subsets, that is 16 subsets we can form. Note that the empty set and the whole set is always a subset of itself. So we have seen 3 sets. The first is an empty set, second is a subset, third is an equal set, and we have seen an important result: the number of subsets in n elements that can be formed, the number of subsets of n elements that can be formed is, the number of subsets of n elements that can be formed is 2 power n. Number of subsets, in fact I should alter this statement slightly, the number of subsets of a set of n elements, n element irukka or set la ethana subset uruvaakka mudiyum appadina 2 power n. The number of subsets of a set of n elements that can be formed is 2 power n. I said that empty set and the whole set is always a subset of itself. The empty set and the whole set. These two subsets are called trivial subsets. So in general, remember this formula, this is an important formula. The number of subsets that can be formed from a set of n elements is 2 power n. So we have seen 3 types of sets. The first is empty set, subset, equal sets, and then we discussed that the number of subsets that can be formed from n elements is 2 power n. And then take a simple formula, symmetric difference, A delta B. We pronounce this by delta. In short form, we call this del. A del B is equal to A minus B union B minus A. Symmetric difference. The next set that we are going to see is a finite set. This is a fourth set. Finite. This is a finite set. A set X is said to be finite if it has k elements. A set X is said to be finite if it has k elements. இப்போ ஒரு செட் எப்போ ஃபைனட் சொல்லுவோம் அப்படின்னா அது போயிட்டே இருக்கக்கூடாது, ஒரு ஸ்டேஜில் நின்றுணும். ஆமாம், நின்றுச்சுன்னா அந்த செட்டு வந்து ஃபைனைட் செட். இன்ஃபைனைட் செட், எ செட் எக்ஸ் இஸ் செட் டு பி ஃபைனைட் இப் இட் ஹாஸ் கே எலமெண்ட்ஸ். இன்ஃபைனைட் செட். If a set is not finite, then it is infinite set. For example, total number of stars in the sky. We cannot say exactly this number of stars there. So this set is infinite set. Now we are going to see an important term called cardinality. We say a finite set x is of cardinality k, and it is denoted by n of x. For example, say x is equal to 1, 2, 3, the cardinality of x is 3, the number of elements. Suppose if I take x is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, here the cardinality of x is 8, since there are 8 elements. So these are the types of sets which are in your book. The first is an empty set, and then a subset, and equal sets, and then we discuss how many subsets that can be formed from a given set. That is 2 power n set subsets. The next is finite set. A finite set, if it has k elements, we say that the set is finite. We say that a set is a sub 3 elements, it is called cardinality. Now we finished top 2 topics, that is a definition of a set and then the types of set. Now we just recall what we saw up to now. The first is definition of a set. A set is a collection of well-defined objects. The term well-defined has to be understood very, very, very clearly. We said, if I pick an element x in A, suppose if I'm damn sure that this set exactly belongs to that set, we say that the set is well-defined. Suppose we are not clear, I am not able to tell exactly whether this belongs to or does not belong to the set, we call this as an it is not well defined. I have given 2 examples of a set which is not well defined, and then I discussed about the types of sets. The first is empty set, subset, and equal sets, and then I discussed one formula. The number of subsets that can be formed from a set of n elements is 2 power n, and then a symmetric difference, and then a finite infinite set, and the cardinality. So we have finished types of sets. Next we are going to move on to properties of set operations. This is the first video, so I am going a little slow. From the upcoming classes, I'll be fast because I want to complete the syllabus within December so that you can have extra time to study. Properties of set operations. I'm just going to quote all the properties. You can take any 2 sets and you can verify all this. I'm not going to verify all these properties. I'm just going to quote all the properties. This is not important, I should say. You just take any 2 sets, say for example A is equal to 1, 2, 3, B is equal to 1, 2, 4, and check whether all these properties are satisfied. The first is commutative, that is A union B is same as B union A, and A intersection B is same as B intersection A. The next is associative. A union B union C is same as A union B union C. These properties are well known to you. You have studied in 10th standard. A intersection B intersection C is same as A intersection B intersection C. And then distributive, A union B intersection C equal to A union B intersection A union C. and then A intersection B union C is equal to A intersection B. Kindly take a note, so it will be very useful to you. A intersection C, this can also be marked as green 1 marks. Which of the following can be a commutative property, so you can able to attend this. And then identity A union empty set is equal to A, and the fifth is idempotent A union A is equal to A intersection A is equal to A. These are two different properties. And then absorption A union A intersection B is equal to A intersection A union B is equal to A. And then we are coming to a very important law which you studied in 10th standard, that is De Morgan's law. That is De Morgan's law. There are 4 De Morgan's law. I'm just going to quote all these. A union B whole dash is equal to A dash intersection B dash. A intersection B whole dash is equal to A dash union B dash. A dash is called complement of A. Third is A minus B union C is equal to A minus B intersection A minus C. Then A minus B intersection C is equal to A minus B union A minus C. Now I'm going to talk about a little bit on complement. Suppose if I have a set A, suppose this is a universal set U consists of all the sets. Suppose this is a set A, this is A complement, that is A complement or A dash. This A complement or A dash. A union B whole dash is same as A dash intersection B dash. A intersection B dash whole dash is equal to A dash union B dash. A minus B union C is equal to A minus B intersection A minus C. A minus B intersection C is equal to A minus B union A minus C. And then we are seeing the properties of set operations. And then there are 3 properties in symmetric difference. The first one, the properties on symmetric difference, that is A del B is equal to, I said earlier, A minus B union. What is that symmetric difference? I already mentioned that here. A delta B is equal to A minus B union B minus A. We are going to see properties of set differences. The first one is A delta B is same as B delta A. This can be asked in 1 marks. Then A delta B delta C is equal to A delta B delta C, and then A intersection B del C is equal to A intersection B in del A intersection C. So we have finished a 3 topic. What are that? The first one we saw is a definition of a set, and then types of sets, and then properties of set operations. So we finished properties of set operations. The last topic for the today's class is Cartesian product. So the last topic of today's class is Cartesian product. Cartesian is a name of a mathematician. He invented this, so he assigned his name as Cartesian product. Cartesian product is nothing. It is a set of all ordered pairs. Cartesian product is a set of all ordered pairs. Suppose consider Consider two sets A and B. The Cartesian product denoted by cross. It should be said as cross, not into, not multiply or like that. It should be said as A cross B. It should be read as A cross B. Is set of all A comma B such that A belongs to A, B belongs to B. The Cartesian product A cross B is equal to set of all ordered pairs. Set of all ordered pairs. Set of all ordered pairs. If I do an example, you will be clear with that. Example. Suppose A is equal to 1, 2, 3. B is equal to AC. B is equal to AC. Then A cross B is the set of all ordered pairs. First take 1 and then make the pair with AC. That is 1, A and 1, C. And then take 2 and then pair with AC. That is 2, A and 2, C. And then take 3 and pair it with 3, A and 3, C. So this is a Cartesian product. It's very simple. You just take 1 and then make a pair with all the elements with B. And then take an element in A, make all the pairs with B. And then 3, similarly you can make a pair. That is, set of all A cross the set 1, A, 1 belongs to A and A belongs to capital B. A cross B. Suppose if I have 2 sets, then suppose if I have 3 sets A, B, C, then the Cartesian product is denoted by A cross B cross C is equal to A, B, C. Such that A belongs to A, B belongs to B, C belongs to C. Very simple. Example, A is equal to 1, 2, 3. B is equal to, say, AB. C is equal to AD. Then A cross B cross C is equal to, first take 1 and then make a pair with A and, in fact, I should say, name it as C, D. 1, A, C and then 1, A, D and then make a pair with B, 1, B, C and 1, B, D and then take and then replace A by B and then 1, B, C, 1, B, D, 1, A, and goes on and you take a 2, so this goes on up to a finite terms. The next question arises, how many elements are there in the Cartesian product? Suppose if we have a set A with cardinality say something, suppose if we have another set B with cardinality something, then how many elements can be formed in, how many elements are there in A cross B? So the next result. It's a result, this can be asked in 1 mark. Result. It's an important result. The number of elements in A cross B is the product of number of elements in A and the number of elements in B. That is, n of A cross B is equal to n of A into n of B. Here the cardinality of A is 3, cardinality of B is 2. So cardinality of A cross B is n of A into n of B, that is 3 into 2, 6. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 elements. So the number of elements in A cross B is cardinality of A into cardinality of B. So here we will have n of A cross B cross C is equal to n of A cross n of B cross n of C. Here n of A is 3, n of B is 2, so it will be 12 elements are there in the A cross B cross C. So what are the topics we discussed today? First, we saw the definition of a set and the types of sets, properties of set operations and Cartesian product. Hope you understand all the topics. Please subscribe for the notification for the next video. Please do like if you understand. Thank you. We'll see you in the next class. Bye. Have a nice day.